All right, fans, and there you see him, the World Tag Team Champions, Rick Rude, the Raging Bull, and the man that put it all together. And it cost him a lot of bucks, but he's reaping the reward now. Number one, Paul Jones.
That's exactly right, Bob. And he really picked his spot. It was just a genius move by the number one man, Paul Jones. And he's got it all together, as you say right now. And it's really going to reap him a lot of dividends.
All right, and the opponents right here for the Bull and Rude are George South and Alan West. Who's going to start here, Johnny?
Alan West in the ring with the Ravishing One, Rick Rude, to start off with. But you know, Jones has got to look around now. He's the man sitting on the top of the tag team world, and he's got the Rock and Roll Express, a team that has a history of getting their tag team belts back when they have lost them on a couple of occasions. And you know they're going to looking real good in our program earlier. They're going to be breathing right down the neck of Rude and Bull. If Jones turns away to look another way, there's a superpower standing there. Right. Dusty Rhodes, Nikita Koloff. Then there's the Road Warriors are hanging around. And also the U.S. Tag Team Champions, Barry Windham and Ronnie Garvin, I know, are going to be looking World Tag Team way.
I tell you, Jones has got to be having some sleepless nights when he thinks about the tag teams that are right behind his fellas and the ones that are trying to move up and take on that championship. He's got to look back and looking behind him all of the time, Johnny. He's got to say that's the greatest lineup of talent in the world that's pushing his champions and right after that championship.
He's so busy bragging about his champions and what he's done, he better look around, because there's a lot of great champions and championship caliber teams breathing right down his neck.
Rude West in the corner, and he's been banging away at him in that corner, the knee to the stomach, and then that forearm.
And Jones is not going to always have that opportunistic spot that he did when he challenged the Rock and Roll. He knew they were hurt. He knew that they could not back down. They had to accept the challenge, and they did, because of the champions that they are. But Jones walked away from that one with a win and the belts, but boy, it's going to be a rough road to hoe, Jones.
Good arm drag and a takedown by Sal. Boy, the Bull quickly on his feet. And Johnny, one thing I've noticed there, you see Jones outside of the ring watching the action, but one thing that you can tell by looking at Rude and the Bull, and that is that Jones has got them in top-notch condition. You see them when they get hurt, they bounce back very quickly. They're in top shape. He's got them ready.
And Bull, the Raging Bull and Rude, a little bit bigger than the Rock and Roll in stature, but they're very quick, just like the Rock and Roll. And we've seen how much that speed is an asset by the Rock and Roll when they won the championships before. The Bull and Rude have got that quickness, got that speed, and it's a great asset.
South reversed that, came with a hip toss now on the Bull, and the Bull quickly up on his feet again. It's like it really makes him mad when his opponent manages to do something. He just gets irate and goes wild in there, gives up to that Dame of the Raging Bull.
Well, that's another quality that they have. They've got that vicious streak in them. Of course, Jones, I'm sure, pumps that into them all the time. And they could get very vicious, both of them, Rude and Bull.
All right, they're going to double team South again.
Oh, Rude Awakening just was perpetrated on George South, and the Rude Awakening gets a victory for the World Tag Team Champions, Bob, with Rude, Raging Bull.
He calls it a Rude Awakening, Johnny, but it puts the